Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Skyrim. We are here in Candlehearth Hall, enjoying lunch in front of this gloriously roaring fire, talking to these fine peoples, Voldessa Girion.
It's good to spend some time on solid land.
She's a sailor. Yeah. Well, I need to be going.
Life on the river makes for weak legs, so I do a lot of walking when we dock.
You sail the river, huh? And there goes my bow again. Alright, well, I am gonna go...
Name's Nils. I'm the cook up at Candlehearth Hall.
Here at Candlehearth Hall, you mean, right? That's what you mean. Okay. Well, I'm not gonna talk to, like, everybody here. Because I have things to go do. I guess. I have to get back to Whiterun, which isn't as cold as here. So that's a plus right there, but yeah. I was actually thinking maybe I'll pop in and see if Ulfric made it back. I mean, this is where he's from, right? He's the leader of Windhelm. Or whatever. Yeah. He was from here. So, last I saw, he was trapped in Helgen because of a cave-in, and I would like to know if he made it back. I'm gonna go in and ask.
Ulfric won't give us a straight answer.
He's a true Nord.
Oh, there he is.
He'll come around.
Don't be so sure of that. We've intercepted couriers from Solitude.
Ooh,
the Empire is putting a great deal of pressure on Whiterun.
And what would you have me do?
If he's not with us, he's against us.
He knows that. They all know that.
How long are you going to wait?
You think I need to send Bolgruuf a stronger message?
If by message you mean shoving a sword through his gullet.
Taking his city and leaving him in disgrace would make a more powerful statement, don't you think?
So we're ready to start this war in earnest, then?
Soon.
I don't think
I still say you should take them all out like you did Dead King Torrig.
Torrig was merely a message to the other Jarls. Whoever we replace them with will need the support of our armies.
We're ready when you are.
Things hinge on Whiterun. If we can take the city without bloodshed, all the better. But if not...
Huh.
The people are behind you.
Many, I fear, still need convincing.
Huh. Hi. Ulfric. Do you remember me?
I remember you.
Yeah.
You were at Helgen with us.
Yeah.
Come to join the war.
Speak
with Garmar. He handles the new recruits.
No, that's not why I'm here. I'm
sorry to hear that. If you change your mind, speak with Garmar. What does bring you to me?
I just wanted to see if you were alive, and you are, and so that's cool. They said you shouted the king to death. What does that mean?
Not entirely true. Though not entirely false, either.
Huh.
Any Nord can learn the way of the voice by studying with the Greybeards. Given enough ambition and dedication. My shouting Torrig to the ground proved he had neither. However, it was my sword piercing his heart that killed him.
Why did you kill the High King?
I killed Torrig to prove our wretched condition. How is the High King supposed to be the defender of Skyrim if he can't even defend himself?
So they call you a murderer?
I challenged him in the traditional way, and he accepted. There were many witnesses. No murder was committed.
Okay.
True, he didn't stand a chance against me. But that was precisely the point. He was a puppet king of the Empire, not a High King of Skyrim. His father before him, perhaps, but not Torrig. He was too privileged and too foolish. More interested in entertaining his queen than ruling his country.
Sounds like a wimp. Do you? Oh, and what of his widow? Doesn't she claim the throne?
Indeed. Elisif has become Jarl of Solitude. Historically and conveniently home of the High King, backed by Imperial interests. But the Moot has not yet met to name her High Queen.
The Moot?
And they won't. Not as long as I have any say in it.
Hmm. So do you desire to be the High King, then?
There hasn't been a true High King in Skyrim for generations. For too long, he's been hand-picked by the Emperor, and given emphatic nods by milk-drinking Jarls addicted to Imperial coin. It's time we had a real High King, one of our own making.
That didn't really answer my question. Are you saying you are a real High King? Hmm? So why are you fighting this war anyways? Yeah, I don't really know a whole lot about the Stormcloak Rebellion. I'm not from here, you see. I'm from Cyrodiil, and it's kind of... I mean, we heard of it, but I don't really know all about it.
We're fighting because we're done bleeding for an empire that won't bleed for us. Untold numbers of Nords died defending the Empire against the Dominion.
Yeah.
And for what? Skyrim being sold to the Thelmor so the Emperor could keep his throne. We're fighting because our own Jarls, once strong, wise men, have become fearful and blind to the people's suffering. We're fighting because Skyrim needs heroes, and there's no one else but us.
My father would like you. My father would definitely like you. How did you become the Jarl of Eastmarch?
My father, the Great Bear of Eastmarch, died during my imprisonment after the Markarth incident.
Markarth incident.
I, his only son, forced to deliver his eulogy via letter I had smuggled out of prison, such as the love of Titus Mead for his subjects. When finally set free, I returned to Windhelm and was greeted by a city in mourning, at one with my own grief and anger, clamoring in angry voices. Calling out for justice, for war, they sat me on the throne.
Oh.
The throne of Ysgrimmor, the throne of my father. I only hope I can prove worthy of that honor.
So, okay, they made you their king, basically. And how is the war going?
The Empire thinks it holds Falkreath from us, but the souls of Skyrim's bravest are buried there and will fill our hearts and strengthen our blades.
All right. Well, it was nice talking to you, Ulfric, and glad you made it out alive. And, yeah. I'm not really interested in joining your war, but good luck, okay? I mean, I really don't know what to think. It's still... You make some good points. But, my father would like you. He wasn't a Stormcloak. He didn't live here, but he's a Talos guy through and through. And he fought in the war, and he was pretty angry about how that went down, so. I can respect your guys' position, I can. I'm just not ready to join your cause for sure. But anyways, good luck.
Go with the gods.
Yeah.
And let them die with their false kings.
We've been soldiers a long time. We know the price of freedom. But people are still weighing things in their hearts.
What's left of Skyrim to wager?
They have families to think of.
How many of their sons and daughters follow your banner? We are their families.
Well put, friend. Tell me, Galmar, why do you fight for me?
I'd follow you into the depths of oblivion. You know that.
Yes, but why do you fight? If not for me, what then?
I'll die before elves dictate the fates of men. Are we not one in this?
I do the cooking and cleaning around the palace.
I fight for the men I've held in my arms, dying on foreign soil. I fight for their wives and children whose names I heard whispered in their last breath. I fight for we few who did come home, only to find our country full of strangers wearing familiar faces. I fight for my people.
impoverished to pay the debts of an empire too weak to rule them, yet brands them criminals for wanting to rule themselves. I fight so that all the fighting I've already done hasn't been for nothing. I fight because I must.
Your words give voice to what we all feel, Ulfric. And that's why you will be High King. But the day words are enough will be the day when soldiers like us are no longer needed.
I would gladly retire from the world were such a day to dawn.
Aye. But in the meantime, we have a war to plan.
Well, he's got passion, that's for sure. Yeah, I've heard similar arguments from my father. He was very mad that fighting all that war and seeing all of his friends and all the men die, and for nothing. They just went home and were under the rule of the Thalmor anyways. I can understand where they're coming from. Anyways, what time is it? Oh, it's almost dinner time already. Well, I think maybe I'll tan some of the hides I've collected and see what this guy has for sale, and then maybe by then it'll be time to get a room at the inn. Alright, so the market is still closed. There's an apothecary, and I wonder if there's anything else. Let's continue exploring the city a little bit. We have not seen everything, for sure. So, what do we got here? Naranya's house. Don't need to go in that. What's this? Calyxo's House of Curiosities.
Can I help you?
Calyxto Corium.
I don't care much for the war, one way or the other.
I wasn't asking you about the war, I was asking about your...
It bothers me that fewer people come to Windhelm these days.
Okay. So this is a house of curiosities, eh? What do we got here? Troll Skull, the Dancer's Pipe. Okay. Dwemer, plates and cups. Interesting. What do we have? Scroll of Harmony. Scroll of Blizzard. Embalming tools. Yuck. Really? So you have lots of... Okay. The Book of Fate. It's empty. Okay, that's somebody's sick idea of a joke, I guess. Now, how is an iron ingot a curiosity, I would like to know? Huh? Yeah, these are definitely curiosities. That's disgusting. That is disgusting. Hag raven feathers. Huh. Alright, well, this isn't... Yuskamor's soup spoon. That's a fork. Okay. This is not a very interesting museum, dude. Sorry, but it's not. All right, so let's see what else. Where does this go? It goes outside.
You're a war hero, Grunwolf. Ulfric will listen to you.
It's not that simple. Ulfric wants Skyrim for the Nords. He doesn't trust what he calls outsiders.
You've seen how we live. Cramped alleys, run-down buildings, few guard patrols. Even the name Grey Quarter is an insult.
I'll speak to Ulfric soon. But I make no promises that I can change his mind.
Hmm.
That's all I ask. With your help, we have a chance to make a better life for ourselves here. For that, I thank you.
There's no glory in war. It's just something they tell soldiers so they'll risk their lives.
Yeah. Oh, was this a store? Sadri's used wares.
Take a good look around. I'm sure you'll find what you're looking for. If not, let me know. I might have it stored away.
Okay.
All my goods are legitimate, which is more than I can say for some.
Okay. What do you have for sale?
Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that.
Alrighty then. Just, you got lots of iron weapons. Okay, what do you have here? Amulet of Xenothor. 10% better prices. So you have a lot of clothing. Alright, lots of different hoods and clothing. Is this a black one? Looks kind of gray. But it could be black. I'm just gonna buy it. Probably be better than the red one, even if it is gray. Yeah. Huh, okay. What do you have here? Nothing interesting, I'm thinking? Nope. Alright, well, do I have anything I can sell you? I have an Amulet of Debella. I don't need that. And I don't want that, so yeah. Some of these rings and stuff that I've been collecting. Yeah, that's a blue one. This looks a little bit more brownish gray, but this one's definitely blue. I think. Or maybe I should try them both on. It's hard to tell in this. Now, I think I might want to keep this leather armor, or this, I mean, shrouded armor, and keep it. I don't know, it's kind of cool looking. Conjurer's potion. I don't need that. All right. Thank you.
Do come again.
If I am ever here again, I will probably come again. Yeah. But now it's getting late. Well, I suppose I can explore a little bit more. What's this? Some kind of establishment. New Guinness Corner Club.
Welcome. Let me know if you want anything. I think I got a clean mug around here somewhere.
This is a tavern, I'm guessing? Yeah, corner club, okay. Kind of dingy. Alright,
Oh, splendid. Another Nord.
Hey, don't talk to me like that. I'm not another Nord.
Come slumming to the Grey Quarter, have you?
Let's see. There have been murders in Windhelm? Why am I asking this question? I already know how the Dark Elves are treated. Why are there so many Dark Elves here, actually?
Where else would we be?
Anywhere
when
else?
When the Red Mountain burned, you could scarcely breathe in Morrowind.
Mm-hmm.
So we came west. Windhelm was the first city on that road. And here we are. If we had known the Nords would be so unwelcoming, we may have kept walking.
Okay. What do you have for sale?
Drink for the thirsty, food for the hungry.
Alright. Oh, you do. You have quite actually a lot of food for the hungry. I could buy a carrot. And, Well, let's see. I think I have mead. Do you have any other kinds of drinks besides mead? Like, I don't know, there was some wine down here. Let's have some wine. I'll take wine. Alright. Thank you.
If you need another drink, I'll be right here.
Mm-hmm. Let's go ahead and have some wine. That would be good. What am I doing?
Apparently, some Nord women were murdered. Not sure why I should care.
Oh. Nord women were murdered, huh?
Things have been a lot worse around here since Ulfric took over.
Really?
It's not the cold of Skyrim that gets to me. It's the stink from the people.
If you don't like it here, why don't you leave? I didn't feel like the other cities in Skyrim had this much prejudice going around. So, there have been murders in Windhelm?
None of that matters to me. Until someone takes a Dunmer, I'll let Windhelm deal with its own problems.
Well, then why did you bring it up if it doesn't matter to you? Huh? Fine. You know, you're not a very pleasant guy.
There should be plenty of space.
No. You hate the Norse just as much as they hate you, you know? How are they supposed to-
When I've made enough money, I'm going to return to Morrowind in Hoth style.
Prejudice works both ways, man. You can't accuse them of being prejudiced if you're prejudiced too. Okay? You're a hypocrite. You know you gotta love people, even if they hate you, or they're just gonna keep hating you, and they'll have good reason to hate you. Anyways.
We're one of the same kind, you and I. I'm glad to have met you.
Yeah. I'm glad to have met you too. Now, she's open-minded. She knows that not all Nords are prejudiced against Dark Elves. Yeah. That guy, Sodri, he's no better than the Nords who hate him. Because he hates them just as much. Alright. Time for a bed, for sure, and, tomorrow we'll head up back to Whiterun. Okay. Breakfast has been eaten. Hello. Nice mustache. And, just warming up by the fire before we go out. It's morning. Yeah.
Never much cared for Windhelm. The place is depressing.
It is a little bit. You're right. Huh. It's cold and dreary and just a lot of stone everywhere. And this guy seems to just never leave the bar stool. Okay. I am ready. Looks like we're gonna have a good day today. Could go see how they treated Deacon while I was gone. Hopefully he had a nice time in the stable. What is this building? Windhelm Stables. Okay, must be where the stable guy lives. Deacon, how did you do? Huh? How'd you do out here in a stable? Had some friends and... Yeah. Alright. I hear Khajiit. Oh, Khajiit camp. Alrighty then, let's just check and see if they have anything for sale.
Come and see what goods I offer.
Madron?
I welcome you, friend. How may I serve you?
What do you have for sale?
Take a look.
You probably don't have anything any different from anyone else's junk. Ooh, wait a minute. What is this? Sanctified Orcish Bow. Undead up to level 7, flee for 30 seconds. I don't want them to flee, I want to kill them! And I can't kill them if they're running away from me. Okay. Yeah, I don't see anything worth getting. Nope. Okay. Yeah. Nothing. Alright, I think I'm good, and I think I sold everything already. I don't have really anything else to sell, so thank you!
May your road lead you to warm sands.
Yeah. Okay. Now we need to find our way back to Whiterun. So, all right. So, go across the river, come along on this road here. Oh, goes past the Valtheim Tower. So then. Oh, that's right next to that. Hey, is that cave I almost went into? It is! And then I decided there's no reason to go in there for nothing. Now there's a reason to go in there, see? It's better just to wait until I have a job. No reason to go risking my neck for nothing. Alright. That's what we're going to do.
Far I have traveled to bring you this way.
Oh, there's a shrine of Talos up on that. Up on that hill right there. I'm surprised the Thalmor haven't destroyed all these shrines. You don't see any shrines of Talos in Cyrodiil. They're just like, they don't exist. Of course, this is Stormcloak territory.
You'd rather be plowing a field? Not me.
Let's just go up here and take a look at it.
So what's your story?
Kind of in a cool place. It's like it's watching the road or watching over Windhelm. Ooh, there's stuff on it. Yeah, it's like it's watching over Windhelm. Probably shouldn't take this stuff. These are offerings. The Talos mistake. Citizens of the Empire. All are, of course, familiar with the deeds of Emperor Tiber Septim, but it is the Emperor's ascent to godhood as Talos that is the subject of this work. Until Tiber Septim's death, there had been but 8 divines: Akatosh, Dibella, Arke, Zenithar, Stendar, Mara, Kinnereth, and Julianos. These gods were, and are, worshipped throughout the Empire, and while some may have different names in the varying provinces, for example, Akatosh is known as Auriel to the Aldmer, and Arke is sometimes known as Arke, all are recognized and revered by all races and creatures, cultures of Tamriel. But when Tiber Septim passed to Aetherius, there came to be a 9th divine, Talos, also called Ysmir, the Dragon of the North. The man who was so loved in life became worshipped in death. Indeed, it can be argued that Talos, the 9th divine, became even more important than the 8 that had preceded him, at least to humans, for he was a god who was once just a man, and through great deeds actually managed to ascend to godhood. And if one human could achieve such a feat, couldn't it be done again? Couldn't all humans aspire to achieve divinity? So we thought, we humans, and so we continued to worship Talos and revere him as the ultimate hero god. But that was then. This is now, and now we know the truth. We were wrong. As citizens of the Empire, we all experienced the horrors of the Great War, and it was not until the signing of the White Gold Concordat, that the treaty between the Empire and the Aldmeri Dominion, that we once again knew peace. One of the most important stipulations of that treaty, as every Imperial citizen is well aware, is that Talos can no longer be worshipped as a god. This edict shook the very foundations of the Empire. There were those who rebelled against the law, indeed, some still do, but the citizens of the Empire must know this. The Emperor did not agree to outlaw the worship of Talos because it was demanded by the Thalmor, the ruling body of the Aldmeri Dominion. Oh, really? He didn't, huh? The Emperor agreed to the outlaw of the worship of Talos because it was the right thing to do. Today, the Emperor, and indeed the Empire itself, recognizes that allowing the worship of Talos was a mistake, for by doing so, by allowing the worship of Talos as a divine, the Empire actually did its people a great disservice, for this only succeeded in weakening the memory of the man, Tiber Septim, and his many extraordinary, though mortal, deeds, and pushing people away from the 8 divines, the true gods, who do deserve our love and reverence. And so, the Empire admits it was wrong. The Talos mistake will not be repeated. May we find centuries of peace and prosperity with our new Thalmor friends, and continue to share a spirituality that binds together all the creatures and races of Tamriel. You know what? While I'm not, like, a big, you know, I'm not religious, and I'm not, like, really one for worshiping any of the gods, because, you know, I'm a rebellious young man who, you know, doesn't go along with his father's stuff, at least not outwardly, right? But I respect my father, and I respect my father's beliefs, and my father believed in Talos, and believes in Talos, still. And if the gods decided to make Talos a god, then who are we to decide that he's not one? He didn't decide he was a god. The gods made him a god. Oh, look, there's no snow anymore. It's still very cold, though. Anyways, yeah, that's just propaganda right there. What is that? I just saw an animal cross the road up ahead that looked pretty large. Where'd it go? There it is, it's walking up there. What is that thing? It's got a little swaying butt. Oh. That looks mean, whatever it is. I think we best continue on our way. Well, this is interesting land. There's, like, not a whole lot of trees and grass. What's this up here? Another mill? Alright, let's see who lives here. Mixwater Mill. Anybody here? Aww, a baby goat. Oh, there we go. Hey. Gilfrey?
Here for work? Get an axe and bring me all the wood you can chop.
No, I'm not here for work.
Until next time.
Okay. Oh. Hi there. It's so cute. Oh, it's a little goat family. That's cute. Alright, so just a woman by herself running a mill. That's different. Okay, well, I'll let her be. Yeah. We must get on our way. Time is a-wasting. Now this is more like it. There is a fort right here. Who runs this fort? Hello? Fort Amol. Oh, no! You threw an ice spike at my horse? No, you don't. Ice apprentice mage. Die! How dare he? How dare he hurt my horse? Deacon, are you okay? Oh my gosh. Oh, there are more of them. Okay. Well, we don't need people like this, just... Yeah... Hello? What is that?
I'm warning you, back off! Never should have come here.
Huh? Burnt corpse. Stormcloak. They're killing travelers. They're just killing travelers. Oh! Are these fur gauntlets better than mine, I wonder? Yeah, you too. You gonna give me trouble? Ow. These are nasty people. They are indeed. What is this? Amulet of Julianos. A shrine of Julianos. All diseases cured. Blessing of Julianos added. What is the Blessing of Julianos? Where does that show up, actually? What is it? It's not showing up. Gold? Is this it? I guess there's probably more inside. Moon sugar. Oh. Huh. I wonder if I should bother dealing with them all. For nothing. Again, for no reward. Because, you know, nobody is telling me to do it. But look at this. They're killing Stormcloaks. Not that that's really any of my business, but... let's just see what they have. Wine. Okie dokie. Oh, it's empty. Well, nice view. Yeah, I'm not gonna bother. This is not really my business. I just killed them because they were trying to kill me. And, if somebody offers to pay me to wipe these guys out, I'll do it gladly, but for now, I'm just gonna be on my way. Ruins. Fort down there, too. There's just forts everywhere here. Huh. Okay. Let's get on with it. Interesting. So, what do we got here? Crossroads. White run. This way. Iverstead, Riften. Sure are a lot of towns we haven't yet to discover. A lot of goats around here. What is up here? Who is this dude? Alright, I'm just gonna get off and... It's a Khajiit.
This one has something sweet for the fellow traveler, if it entices.
What? You're a really tough-looking dude. What are you talking about?
The finest skooma.
Oh.
The sweetest moon sugar.
No, I don't want skooma.
At a fair
skooma.
Price, of course.
I don't want skooma. Skooma's... Is skooma even legal? No, thank you.
Each has their own way.
Yeah. This is not my way. I'm just gonna just go up here real quick to see what's up here. Ooh, creepy. This looks like an old Nordic pilgrim's tomb. Hello? Hi. Are you living here? Because that's kind of creepy.
Ah! Oh, my kind, you startled me.
What do you mean?
There's a necromancer around here, so watch yourself. Can you help me? He's in the tomb doing gods know what with my dead relatives.
Oh, this is your tomb? Who's in there?
Vals Varen. My family has never really seen eye to eye with him. And he has finally gone off the deep end. He's gone in to defile our family tomb by using our ancestors for his filthy dark elf necromancy.
Ew.
My aunt went in after him, but she hasn't come out yet. And I don't think I can take him by myself.
You let your aunt go in there by herself?
I'm not proud of it. I'm terrified of that place, and Aunt Agna knows it. My dad locked me in there in a drunken rage when he left us.
Oh.
3 days in there eating the offerings left for our dead before Aunt Agna found me.
That's
Can
horrible.
You help me? He's in the tomb doing gods know what with my dead relatives.
Well, will you offer me anything for help? All right, fine, I'll help you. Be kind of callous of me not to, wouldn't it?
Great. I'll unlock the door and meet you inside. Then you can lead the way.
Okay. Can I take this while we're at it? So there's a guy in there who's doing who knows what to a dead people. Creepy. Okay. It's dark. Let me just get my lantern on here. Okay. Nice. So, dead relatives, huh? This is your family's tomb. Oh, well. Okay, well, there's one on the ground. I hear footsteps. I don't think your relatives are just that dead anymore. Don't get in my way, dude. Come on. Ow. Okay. Huh. Hopefully we find your aunt still alive. I'm gonna take a couple of these just because I... Okay, he looks potentially like he's gonna walk right off of here. Yeah. Lots of oil on the ground here. That's another ancient Nord helmet that's invisible. That's not weird. Pretty weird indeed. A mead barrel? That's kind of gross. And how would you like to be buried like this? With your head sticking out of a little hole like this. Odd. People bury your dead in weird ways for sure. Well, let's keep going then. Heh. You're glad I came along, aren't you? Yes, you are. Alright, hold on a second. I see a chest over here. You don't mind if I look you through your things, your family's things, do you? Because I have a feeling you're not going to pay me as much as I want to be paid. Oh!
Hey! Those belong to my family!
Well, sorry!
Fine. Take whatever you want. So long as you help me get rid of Vals.
Yes, that was my thoughts exactly, you know? I deserve a little bit of payment. Okay. Cape of the Lover.
No. Aunt Agna.
Oh.
Talos, why didn't I go in with her?
Because you're a coward. Because you are a coward, dude.
He's barred the door. Gods only know how he's defiling the bodies of my ancestors in there.
Yeah.
Agna once told me there's a secret room deeper in, where they buried disgraced members of the family. Maybe that will get us into the main chamber.
Disgraced members of the family. Okay. Well, we can try, I guess. Oh, here comes one. Wait, no. Oh, there's another one. I thought I heard another one. You got him? Well, good for you. Good for you. Bone meal. Okay. Anything else? Okay. Oh my gosh! Already. Whew. This is just normal for you, huh? It's just normal. Okay. Nothing good in any of these. Yeah, you're not even batting an eye at all this. All of your urns are empty. Why do you bury empty urns? Are these just waiting? Are these here waiting for your future? I could sell that. Future people? Future dead people? So we got two ways to go here. Not sure which is the right way. You put this guy in backwards. This one too. Yeah, I can sell these helmets. Aren't very heavy, and they're worth a lot, actually. Okay. So, are these the? I accidentally took the hide armor. I didn't want the hide armor. Huh. All right. These are the most brittle lockpicks ever in the world. Oh! I just got my lockpicks back. Okay, so I guess we're going this way then. Ow! Look out, there's a trap there. Didn't see that. Ow, that hurt. Okay, jump over it. Padded fur hood black. Oh, that's worth a lot for the weight. kind of gross that I just took that off a mummified corpse, but whatever. Huh. Okay, that one looks like it could come alive. Oh, yes. All right. Let's do that. Stamina. And let's see. I still can't upgrade my light armor. How about my one-handed? Ooh, I almost can do one-handed. So what's this one? This is for war axes. That's for maces. Swords have a 10% chance of doing critical damage. Huh. Okie dokie. I would like to put some perks into smithing. That way I can get access to other items to craft. And also arcane blacksmith. That means that I can improve magical weapons. Because I don't actually want to carry any magical weapons unless I can improve them. Maybe I'll start doing smithing. Alright. Okay! There's a spider. Okay.
It's not the...
Did you get hurt? Okay. Is this a dead end? No. What is this? There's a skeleton in there, apparently. Okay. Nope, not a dead end. Okay. Okay. We got a few. Look out behind you. There's a couple archer ones. Oh, don't laugh at me like that. Got him?
This looks like the area Agna told me. She said that the bear would show the way.
The bear would show the way. Alright. What bear? The bear would show the way. Oh. Ha! It's good. Of course. So the bear is the one that has the chain on it.
You found it. Passage goes through the sarcophagus. Oh, I don't like this. But we'd better keep going.
Yeah. Okay. Let's go.